Illustrator Patterns.
Hi, I'm James and welcome to Pattern Designers. I hope you're having a great day wherever you are in the world. In this video, I'm going to walk you through two methods on how to make Illustrator patterns. I'll be using Adobe Illustrator CC, and be sure to stick around to the end to get our free textile designer cheat sheet.
My equipment. In this tutorial, I'll be using a MacBook Pro 17 inch, a Wacom Intuos, and Adobe Illustrator. Set up your artboard. Here are the elements we're going to use to make our pattern in Illustrator, but first we're going to set up the artboard. So just press Apple N for new, and I'm going to choose 1000 pixels by 1000 pixels. And in centimeters, I think that's roughly 35 centimeters. Yep. So all this is good, it's just a square. All this can stay the same and create. And there we have our new artboard. Making your Illustrator pattern design, method one. Okay, let's get started. We've got our fresh artboard and I'm just gonna go to my elements, select them all, copy them and paste them into a new artboard. Then I'm just gonna outline them because they've got a brush effect on them, which I need to outline. Let's have a look, yep, that's good. And so method one for repeating, I'm just gonna reduce them so we've got a bit more. There we are. I'm just going to make it a one-way repeat. No, actually, I'm going to make it a two-way repeat, so it's a bit more dynamic. And then I'm going to select them all and go up to Object and Pattern and Make. Then this opens up this new window. You see how the spacing's pretty okay. I'm just going to increase the width slightly. Then I'm going to put something here. What can I put there? Put another orange dino there. And that's good. So I'm just gonna press done up here to get out of the pattern. And we're left with the original elements that we had. I'm just gonna shift those off the artboard and zoom out slightly. Make a box for this. There we go. And in our swatches now, we should have a pattern, which is our dinosaur pattern. Looks pretty fresh, I like it. And if you want a background, it's really easy to just copy that square out and put a background in whatever color you want. So you want to make it green or blue. Let's see what it looks like, red. Red's pretty wild. Let's see what it looks like with that. Oh, I like that dark blue, it looks sick. So that's method one, making your Illustrator pattern design, method two. So now method two, I'm gonna delete method one, which is this, and bring these bad boys back onto the artboard as I've already started to arrange them. So I'm gonna use a box, which is gonna be, let's make it even, so 660, no, let's say 600. By 488. Let's make it 5. And then I'm going to send that to the back. I'm going to start arranging. We've already got our spacing pretty well organized. I'm just going to move these up. So these ones, this top layer, I want to move them 600 down. So 600 height. So copy, paste in front, and it'll paste them all in front. So paste in front is Command F. Then I plus 600 that to move them down. And then I'm going to delete that dino because it's in the way. Next, let's organize this left-hand side. I'm just going to move these over. So I'm going to copy these on the left hand side. So copy, Command F in front. And then on the X axis, we're going to plus 500, which moves them to the right hand side. Now all I have to do is organize the interior. The square is the repeat. So if we copy and paste that Command C, a Command F in front, a Command Shift bracket, it brings it to the front, and I can select all and then Command 7, and there we have our pattern. So our pattern is 600 by 500 pixels. I can just go to the swatches and drag this in, but what I might have to do, yeah, if I go and double click into that pattern, I need to make it 500 by 600 because it's using the outside of all the elements. And they have method 2. So here's method 2, this is method 1, and this is method 2. Spacing's a bit different, but kind of pretty similar result.
Now, I hope you found this Illustrator pattern tutorial helpful. The two methods I've covered are the ways I use Illustrator to produce patterns daily for my job as a textile designer. Be sure to download our free textile designer cheat sheet. The link is in the description. Subscribe and remember to press the bell icon to get notified about new videos. Like this video, comment below if you'd like to see any new tutorials, if there's anything that you need help with. Make sure you comment below and give us feedback on what you would like to see next. And I will see you in the next video. Peace.